Hey, fantastic fourth graders, and we are back with some more practice sentences that we will classify. These can be found on page 211 in your language packet for this week. It is chapter 5, lesson 5. First, you talk about some vocabulary and analogy with the word industry, and then it reviews with you spelling rule number 2, where we add where we have to decide whether we add an S or the letters ES to the end of words to make them plural. And then finally we go to classifying sentences. So these are the 3 sentences that are on page 211 in your language packet this week. And so I'm going to go through the question and answer flow with these, as you should be doing at home, and labeling your sentence as you go. Or you may be watching this after you've already labeled them on your own and you're just checking to make sure that you got it all right. So, let's go. Number 1, ready, set, read. Search for your lost baseball at the ballpark after school. Now, the first thing I'm going to do is look for my verb, my action verb. And so, in this sentence, my verb is search. So, I'm going to ask a question that sounds sort of weird because it doesn't sound grammatically correct the way we ask it. But the question is, who searched for your lost baseball at the ballpark after school? And our subject for that is, or our answer to that question is you. And it is an understood you. And you is a subject pronoun. Okay? So, who searched for your lost baseball at the ballpark after school? You, subject pronoun. What is being said about you? You search, verb. For, preposition. For what? Baseball, object of the preposition. Lost, what is this word describing? Or what question does it answer? It answers the question, which baseball? Lost. Adjective. That's right, the lost baseball. Whose baseball? Your. Possessive pronoun, adjective. At. Preposition. At what? Ballpark. Object of the preposition. The. Article, adjective. After, and there's a word that comes after this, so we're going to assume that after is a preposition. So after, preposition. After what? School, object of the preposition, which verifies that after in this sentence is actually a preposition because it has an object of a preposition. Okay? Subject, noun, verb, pattern 1. Skill check. Let's look for prepositional phrases. For your lost baseball, prepositional phrase. At the ballpark, prepositional phrase. After school, prepositional phrase. Period, command, imperative sentence. Go back to the verb, divide the complete subject from the complete predicate. Underline the complete predicate once and the complete, I'm sorry, underline the complete subject once and the complete predicate twice. It's really easy to get mixed up and say the wrong word sometimes, so double check what you're saying. All right, number 2. Ready, set, read. Aunt Sally retired after 31 years with the phone company. Let's look for our verb. What's happening in this sentence? Retired. That's right, past tense verb. Who retired after 31 years with the phone company? Aunt Sally. Now, aunt is not an adjective in this sentence. Aunt Sally is one person. This is just her title, much like it would be if it said Mrs. Prickett or Miss Ball. So Aunt Sally is the subject noun, and we put it in the center of those two words to show that they go together. Okay? Who retired after 31 years with the phone company? Aunt Sally. Next question. What is being said about Aunt Sally? Aunt Sally retired. Verb. After. Preposition. After what? Phone? No. After years. Object of the preposition. 31. What question does this answer? Of course it answers the question, how many years? 31. So it's an adjective. With preposition. With what? Phone? No, she didn't retire with the phone. She retired with what? Company. Object of the preposition. What does phone answer? It would answer which company or what kind of company, and so phone would be an adjective. The article adjective. Subject, noun, verb, pattern one. Skill check, look for prepositional phrases. After 31 years, prepositional phrase. With the phone company, prepositional phrase. Period, and this is a statement, so it's a declarative sentence. Go back to the verb, retired. Divide the complete subject from the complete predicate. Underline the complete subject once and the complete predicate twice. Very good. Okay, ready? Number three, ready, set, read. The oversized rug fits snugly in our small bedroom. What fit snugly in our small bedroom? If you said rug, that is correct. Rug is our subject noun. What is being said about rug? Rug fit, verb. Snugly. What question does this answer? I hope that you said it answers the question how or fit how. Snugly. And that would be an adverb. Because adverbs answer how, when, and where. In. Preposition. In what? Bedroom. Object of the preposition. What kind of bedroom? Small. Adjective. Here's the word our. What question does it answer? Whose bedroom? Our. Possessive pronoun adjective. Okay, now we've still got some words here, so let's go back to these. Oversized. What question does this answer? Well, it seems like it's probably describing the word rug. What kind of rug? Oversized. Adjective. And this is one of those hyphenated words. It's two words that are hyphenated. And they're hyphenated because they're an adjective, okay? And then the article adjective. Subject, noun, verb, pattern one. Skill check. Prepositional phrases. There's only one. In our small bedroom. Period, statement, declarative sentence. Go back to the verb, which is right here because we labeled it. Divide the complete subject from the complete predicate. Underline the complete subject once and the complete predicate twice. And that is how you classify the three sentences on page 211. I hope this was helpful, guys. Hope to see you soon. Bye.